Good afternoon, students. Let us continue the lesson. The topic calendar. Okay. Here, in the previous session, we learned how to read a calendar and answer few questions. It is very easy. Clear. Now, the next step under the calendar is calculating the number of days. Okay. Sometimes we may go on a leave, or we get vacation. Or sometimes we order newspaper for particular days, like it may be 1 month or 1.5, and then we may stop. So we just need to know how many days the vacation or how many days we went for a course. You all go for dance class, for music class, or even to learn some instrument. Yes, it may have the period of certain month only or certain number of days. It may not be having for continuity of 2 to 3 years, like. So we just have to find the calculating the number of days. How to calculate from particular one day to the other day? How many days we have a vacation? How many days we went for a course? Or how many days we ordered newspaper? Or so on. Okay. So let us see how to calculate number of days. As you all know that there are how many months in a year? 12 months. You all know, correct? How many months, children? 12 months in a year, from Jan to December. Now, you all know that we have certain number of days in a particular month. So, January has 31 days. February has 28 or 29 days, depending on the year. Okay. If it is a leap year, you will have 29 or we will have 28 days. And so on. Some months may have 30 days. You may remember one song, right? 30 days of September, April, June and November. Yes. So only 4 months in a particular in a year we have 30 days, rest all 31 days, and February has 28 or 29 days. So these number of days of a particular month, you should be thorough with that. Then only you will be able to calculate the number of days. Okay, let us see now. Page number 45 of your textbook. Page number 45. You can see measuring a period of time. There, Surekha went to her uncle's village in the month of May. She went swimming every day from 9th to 25th of May. When she went to her uncle's place, she did not waste her time. She went to a swimming course. Okay, she went to a swimming class, but it was from 9th to 25th May. Okay, she did not go for 1 month or 2 months or 1 year. It was only during her vacation, during her holidays, when she went to stay there. She just went for the course from 9th to 25th. Okay. Now remember, children, here there are two rules. Okay. When to calculate the, while calculating the number of days. First thing what you have to see, first and foremost thing you have to see, whether the asked number of days is the same month. Okay, we just have to see whether we want to calculate the number of days only for a particular month. It is not to May and to some other month. Okay, only the particular 1 month. If only 1 month we need to calculate, it is very easy. But if it comes for 2 to 3 months, then we have to be very careful. So here in your textbook, in our textbook, there is a simple method is given. What they have done is, they have kept like the dots. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, and 25. Okay, so what is the method shown here? Since it is the same month, what they have done, they have kept dots like this and they have started counting from 9th to 25th. Because Surekha went to the swimming class, she joined on 9th and till 25th she went to the class. So now, after keeping these dots, they have counted. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. So, how many days? 17 days. So, Surekha went to the course for 17 days. Do you think, children, it is very easy to keep like dots like this and calculate? It is not so easy. It is very time consuming, right? It is if it is for 2 to 3 months, will you be able to keep dots like this one full page and then you will sit and count? No, it is very tedious work. It is very time consuming, right? So let us see the shortcut way how to find out the number of days here. See, here she started on 9th till 25th. Clear? So you just have to subtract the numbers. So here 25 minus 8. Now you may be asking, teacher, she joined on 9th. Why I wrote here 8? Because she joined the class on 9th. So till 8 she was free. She was just, you have to take one day before. Can you subtract one day before you should take? So here 25 minus 8. You all know subtraction, right? So can I subtract from 5, 8? No, I need to borrow. So here this will be 1. This will become 15. So 1 and 17. So this method is very easy, children. Yes, so 17 days. Instead of keeping the dots and writing the numbers and then counting, which is very time consuming and it is not so easy because it is for 1 month, it was okay. To some extent you could have done. But if it is for May, then again so 2-3 months. Okay, May, June, July. Then how you will do that with keeping the dots? It is not so easy. So subtracting the number of days, you will get the number of days for what the course she went. Clear? She joined on 9th and she continued till 25th. So here 25 minus 8. One day before, one number you have to less here. So you will get exact the number of days. Clear? Let us see one more example. The first example, page number 45. Exercise, solve the following problem. In a certain year, the Ganesh festival started on the 9th of September. In a particular year, Ganesh festival started on 9th of September. Clear? And ended on 18th of September. We have to calculate how many days the festival continued. Clear, children? So here the festival started on 9th and continued till 18th. Ended on 18th. So both the days has to be included. Now what is the first rule I told you have to see first before calculating the days? We just have to see whether both the month are same. Yes, here this is also September, this is also September. So it is very easy. So what I should do? I should subtract 18 minus what? Here, I should subtract 18 minus 8. Very good. One day, one number less than this. So, here, 18 minus 8 is. So, the festival we had celebrated for how many days? 10 days. So, it is very easy, children. Understood? First thing you have to see is write like this. First step is you have to write what is the given date from which date to the next day. Okay, and then second you have to see whether both the dates are of same month. If it is same month, it is very easy, just have to subtract. While subtracting, take the bigger number up and the first number you have to take one number less. Here it is 9 means you will take 8. Here if it is 7 means you will take 6. Here if it is 5 means you will take 4. 18 minus 8 is 10 days. Clear? Let us move on to the next example. Question 2. Now here, Seema, in your second sum, Seema reached her hometown for Deepavali on the 12th of November. As we all go to our village to see our grandparents, right? During the vacation. So here Seema also went to her village for Diwali on 12th of November. She started on 12th and stayed there. Okay, and stayed there till 1st of December. 12th November to 1st December. how many days did she spend there? So we need to find out how many days she stayed with her grandparents in her hometown. Okay, now here first what we have to write like this, I have written. What the second thing I should see? I should see whether both the month are same. Here we had September, here also September. So only one time we subtracted. No issue, no problem. Okay. Now when we come to this side, just check. It is November and this is December. Both the months are same? No. This is different. November and December are both are different months. So there is one more step involved. It is also easy, but just one more step is involved. Okay. Now just before that, November has how many days? November we have 30 days. Okay, November we had 30 days and now she went to village on 12th. Okay, so what did I say? We have to subtract, but I should take 12 or 11 here? 11, very good. So I will take minus 11. That means 11 days she was here in Bombay. 12th day, 12th November she was with her grandparents. So here 30 minus 11. Yes, again here you all know how to subtract. So November 19 days she was there in the village. November how many days? 30 minus 11 is 19 days. Okay. Now December she was there till 1st December. Now December 1 day. December she was there for how many days? 1 day. November how many days? 19 days. Therefore 19 plus 1 equal to 20 days. Clear children? Only this step is extra. Here this two, because here also one more month, we need to see how many days are there in that particular month and then add both the days. Clear? So the first thing, Seema went to the hometown for Diwali vacation and she went on 12th November. She continued staying there till 1st December. So the first thing what we saw here, whether both the month are same, both are different. So calculate November separate, calculate December separate and then both the answer, add it down. Clear? Got it? Is it very easy? Instead of keeping dots, okay, dots and then writing the numbers and then counting them, it is very time consuming and very tedious work. Need to subtract like this. Now when I took November as how many days? 30 days. But she was 12th November, she was with her grandparent. So minus one number less than this. Clear children? Understood? One more example. Okay. The third sum of your textbook is a school trip was from 5th of December. Okay. The school had a trip from 5th December to 10th of December. I have written. Okay. Now how many days was it? We just have to find out how many days was the school trip. Okay. Now first thing I wrote the number. Okay. Now the second thing what I should see, whether both the month are same. This is also December. This is also December. So it is very easy. What should I do? I should subtract now. Now I should subtract 10 minus. Which number should I write here? Directly 5 I will write here. No, I will write one number less than this. So, what is that one number less? 4. Because your trip started on 5th. 5th you were not at home. You were in the trip. So, here 10 minus 4. Again, this becomes 0. So, your trip was for how many days, children? 6 days. Okay? So, this is very easy. When the month is same, it is very easy to calculate. Now, let us see one more example. The last example. Question number 4 of your textbook, page number 45. These all sums, the how to do in a proper pattern, I will write in the Google Classroom and I will post it. Last one, Shyam Rao had milk delivered. Okay, a person, Shyam Rao, he had delivered milk to his home from 5th of November. He started having delivered the milk 5th of November to 5th of December. And then he stopped. Then he doesn't want. So he stopped. So we just have to calculate how many days the milk was delivered to him. So how much he has to pay to the milkman. Clear? Now, first thing I wrote the numbers. Second step, check the month. Both are same. No, this is November, this is December. That means what should I do? I should calculate number of days in November separate, calculate number of December in separate, and add both the numbers. You will get the total number of days for which Shyam Rao have to pay the money to the milkman. Clear? So here November has how many days? 30 days. Very good. November has 30 days. Now he started having milk delivered on 5th November. So which number should I write here? Yes, very good. 4, one number less. So minus 4. Now you know how to subtract. Yes children, from 0 I cannot subtract 4. So I am borrowing. So here 10 minus 4 is 6 and 2. So in the month of November, 26 days milk was delivered. Clear? Well, let us calculate for December. December, how many days? Till 5th December, the milk was delivered. So here, December, 5 days. Total 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Total 5 days, we have to take it full. Clear? So, November, the milk was delivered for 26 days. December, it was delivered for 5 days. Now, add up this two number, you will get the total number of days. So, here therefore, 26 plus 5, that is 31 days. Clear children? Have you understood how to calculate when both are different month? Clear? Have you all understood? Hope it is very easy to calculate the number of days. Okay? Like this only you practice at home. How many courses? You must have gone for drawing class. You must have gone for music class. Okay, your mother pays the fees, right? So, just calculate the number of days. Or you must be ordered for, you must have ordered for newspaper at home. Whatever. So, how many, from which day to which day you ordered? Just calculate the number of days. Just practice this at home more. Okay? Thank you, children.